गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग संतोष जी।
सो आफ्टर गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। अबाउट द वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द रामसा, व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट फीचर्स, व्हाट आर द एक्चुअली द रामसा प्रोग्राम, एंड वी हैव ऑल्सो सीन the some of the quality intervention that was proposed under the Ramsa, and some of the intervention for making available the infrastructure, the physical facility under the program. So today we will have discussion on the equity intervention under the Ramsa program. And from the previous discussion, we have established that the Ramsa program was based upon the equity, philosophy of equity, not on the philosophy of equality. Equality is a different thing, equity is a different thing. And the philosophy of Ramsa program was even the SSA program, because the Ramsa is very much influenced from the SSA program. Even when we see the another program, that is the RUSA, Rashtriya Uchchatar Shiksha Abhiyan, that was also based upon the philosophy of equity, not equality. So can somebody define that what is the equality and what is the equity, and how the equity is different from the equality? Yes, please.
Sir, equity means equality with justice.
Equity means
equality with justice.
Equality with justice. So what kind of a justice? Suppose that here Umakant is there, and Debasis is there, and Jyoti is there, Susmita is there, and I am giving the equal opportunity to all. Whatever I am talking, I am talking to all. Whatever the support I am giving, giving the support to all. So I am doing the justice now with them. I am not stopping someone. I am not restricting someone. So is this kind of
this is equality.
This is a equality.
Sir, if it is need based according, if it is need based according to our need, then it is equity.
Yes. That is very much correct. When we talk about the equality, so equality is giving the opportunity, not discriminating others. Suppose that there are some boys and girls, or there are some students from the different section of a society based upon the social categorization, or based upon their locality, from urban, rural, tribal. So I am giving the equal opportunity. I am not discriminating. That is the equality. On my part, I am not discriminating. Whether you are a boy or girl, or from a rural area or a urban area, or any background, where you are from a socially disadvantaged group or socially advantaged group. So I am not discriminating. So that is the equality. But when we talk about the equity, it will also have a essence of not discriminating, non-discriminatory environment, but the environment will be the need based, based upon your specific need, the program or the policy or whatever the intervention or whatever I am doing, that will be based upon the specific need of the stakeholders, a specific need of the person in particular, if we want to talk. In meanwhile, Susmita has also replied, equity is the treating all as same, equality is treating all as same, and equity means give according to their need. Yes, very much correct. Yes, equity means need based, means fairness, means as per their your need. for sake of example, suppose that I am talking, teaching you with the lecture method, okay, or I am engaging you in the observation. But for sake of example, while I am engaging in your you in the learning environment in observation, but some are with the visual impairment. So I am not discriminating, but whatever I have planned, that is not working for them. So it may be equality, but it is not based on the philosophy of equity. And if we will fail to provide the equity, whatever I am doing for creating a better learning environment, that won't work, because that kind of a planning is not suitable to all children. Or suppose that I am teaching with the lecture method. So those who are with the hearing impairment, they will not get benefit out of it. So I am not discriminating. However, my modality of teaching, my modality of engaging in the learning environment is not well suited to all children. So I am not providing the equity environment where all will be equitable, not equal. Equal though they will be, but equitable. So we must think about the equitable society, and whatever the plan, the policy we use to frame for a different purpose, that must be based upon the philosophy of equity, not a equality. Because nowadays that is very much important for a country like India, because country like India is very much diversified. They have a diversity in terms of the gender, they have a diversity in terms of the cultural practices, geographical location, and so many diversity we have. And that's why the Ramsar program also talks about the equity, not a equality. And what were the different intervention on the part of the equity of this program? The first intervention that this program talks about, that is the micro planning. You must have a micro planning. Can you tell that what is the micro planning? What do you understand by the micro planning? What is the micro planning? Have you heard of this word?
Sir, micro teaching.
Micro teaching, you have heard of that. Achha, theek hai. Anybody you have heard of that, about micro planning?
Okay.
But you have heard of that, the micro teaching. Theek hai. So what we used to do in the micro teaching? Can you tell me what we used to do in the micro teaching?
Sir, a small group, jaise 3-4 student ko lekar hum teaching dete, isi ko micro teaching.
Teaching karte hain, but teaching ke pehle kya karte hain? Aap jaakar class mein 4-5 student plan karte hain. Acha, plan karne ke pehle kya karte hain? Planning.
Plan karne ke liye sochte hain.
Plan karne ke liye sochte hain. Acha, sochne ke baad aur planning karne ke pehle. इन बिटवीन क्या करते हैं? आपने सोच लिया कि आई हैव टू प्लान, एंड आफ्टर सम मोमेंट यू विल कम विथ अ प्लान. ठीक है, यहाँ पे आपने सोचा, यहाँ पे यू हैव कम विथ अ प्लान. सो इन बिटवीन व्हाट यू विल डू?
प्रैक्टिस
करते हैं. अच्छा, एनालिसिस करते हैं. वेरी गुड. Fix an objective. Sriman is replying. Sunanda is replying that we make a blueprint. Yes, very good.
Blueprint.
Achha, blueprint karne ke liye kya karte hain? Aise hi blueprint bana dete hain.
So, teaching items kya rahega, objectives kya rahega, us
ko decide karte hain. Decide karne ke baad we come with a blueprint. Theek hai. So, I will consolidate all your responses. See, in micro teaching, what we are doing, ultimately we are a teaching. And why it is a micro teaching? Because it is not an actual classroom. we used to have a simulated classroom. And when we are doing a micro teaching, it is not an actual classroom. Actual classroom, you are going during your internship. So that is the actual classroom. But in the micro teaching, we used to have a simulated classroom. Suppose that from your classes, some student will act as a student of class 8. Actually, they are not in the class 8. Remember, they are acting as they are in the class 8. And you will go with some of the content you are intended to teach from class 8. And you will teach. But why it has been named as a micro teaching? Because micro means the very small object, tiny object. Literally meaning is that micro means very tiny, very small object. So during the micro teaching, we are considering and planning every small part of the teaching process. We are planning for that. We are preparing for that. And then we are going to the classroom for the teaching learning process. But initially, we are not going to the teaching learning process because we are in the learning phase. So, what exactly we used to do in the micro teaching means the micro, a small object. We consider every small point like that. What content I am going to teach? First, I will decide. 8th class, I am going to teach. In 8th class, mathematics, I am going to teach. In the mathematics, about the triangle I am going to teach. In the triangle, properties of triangle only I will, or type of a triangle only I will teach in the one class. So, I have come to the micro level, a small point. I have started with the class 8, mathematics, geometry, trigonometry, then the type of a triangle, very small thing we have considered. And then by considering that, topic is now final. Then what are the concept and a sub-concept within that? For and how that main concept and a sub-concept is linked to each other? We will do the content analysis. We used to do the content analysis. So, we will see what are the main concept, what are the major concept, what are the sub-concept, minor concept and how it is linked with each other. Then after doing a content analysis, we have identified these are the points that I am supposed to discuss. Then what will be the objective? What will be the teaching method? What will be the teaching learning equipments? How I will engage? What kind of a learning outcome I have thought of? What kind of a question I will ask? How I will start engaging in the learning process? How I will evaluate? Every micro thing we consider. For what? To have a successful learning engagement of the student so that we can achieve the objectives whatever I have framed out of my teaching. And that's why we used to say it is a micro teaching where everything you are considering in a simulated classroom. And when the term came, I will give the brief history also. Actually, in the India, we were not having the micro teaching session in the teaching learning process, that is the teacher training process. So earlier it was conceptualized and experimented in America. And the B.K. Passy, I think you must have heard of them. This is the very famous name in the education and the teacher training program, B.K. Passy. B.K. Passy went there for the academic program and he learned there what is this micro teaching. And the B.K. Passy has experimented the micro teaching concept in the teaching learning process in India. So, credited to the B.K. Passy. And at that time, there were so many scholars working under the B.K. Passy. One of the scholars was the M.S. Lalit Amma. I think you must not have heard of that, M.S. Lalit Amma. Actually, I am blessed to be a student of her, MSL Lalitam, and I have met the several times to the BK Passi also when he was coming to the RI. 2-3 times I have met BK Passi. So MS Lalitamma, when I was in the Pondicherry, she was my dean school of education. So I am blessed to be interacted with the these two personality. So they have experimented and they have populated this concept of a micro teaching. Whereas now come to the point, Guru Prasad has replied that can we call it as a rehearsal before teaching? There is a difference between rehearsal and having a simulated classroom. In the rehearsal, suppose that you are going to act something or you are going to do something or something. Suppose that you are going to deliver a speech in front of everybody or you are going to demonstrate something. So what you used to do, you do a rehearsal in the home that whatever I am planning to demonstrate, how it is working, whether it is working or not, or like that. Or when you are going to deliver a lecture, so you are delivering in front of some of your friend, so rehearsal them to build a concept. Whereas the micro teaching concept means this process is based upon learning. Because we don't know how to teach, how to handle the situation in the real classroom. So through the simulated classroom, we are learning. But when we will learn the concept, we may rehearsal. So rehearsal is the next step. The main objective motto of the simulated classroom micro teaching is to learn, because we don't know how to do a content analysis. We don't know how to prepare a lesson plan. We don't know how to frame an objective. So we are not rehearsing. Once we will learn the thing, then we will rehearsal. But here we are learning. It is a learning process, not a rehearsal process. Okay. What about DWLN? Achha. So DWLN was not directly linked to the micro teaching process that has happened in the India. Actually, the BK Passi has brought this micro teaching in India, and it was developed by the DWLN, but it was not, when we talk about the Indian perspective, that's why I have told that it was developed in the America and the Western country. Okay, and at that time when it came to the India, it was more popular in the American country. Okay. So it has been brought to the India by the BK Passi. Okay. So now come to the point, because we had a lot of discussion over that. So micro planning was one of the things that was emphasized for ensuring a equity intervention. Why the micro planning was focused? Because in order to assure the equity in the learning opportunity at a secondary level, we need to understand the specific need of the different section of a society, different children in the society, because the children have the specific need. As I told you, some of them may not be able to come to the class because they are engaged in the some other activity to earn the livelihood, to earn the money for the family. For the some of the student, it may be that the school is very distant from their home, so they are not able to come. For some of the girl children, the school environment don't seems to be secure. It doesn't have a facility. For some of the children, the methodology which we are using for teaching learning, it is not well suited. The curriculum and syllabus that we are using, it is not well suited. The examples we are using, that is not well suited. For disadvantaged children, it may not be possible to come to the school because of the societal norms. Like that, so many hurdles was there. So many things was there, and as a result, the student were not able to complete the secondary school education. So outcome was that they were not able to complete, either the enrollment was less, or if they have been enrolled, their retention was very less, means the dropout rate was very high, they were not able to complete. Okay, so that's why it was decided that in order to success the secondary education mission, that is a RAMSA, we have to plan at a micro level, means every tiny object, every small thing we have to consider, whether it is related to the girl, whether it is related to the boy, whether it is related to the disadvantaged section, whether it is related to the malnutrition, whether it is related to the distance of a school and a home. Okay, so that was visualized that if we will do a micro planning, then only it will become a success, because every child has a different need. Even that was the some of the need that requires the attention on the part of the societal norms or a physical infrastructure or like that. But some of the need was based upon the individual interest of the child. I am not interested to learn physics, chemistry, biology, all those things. I am interested to get some skill for earning my livelihood. So the vocational input should be there. Because all of us may not continue up to the 10th, 12th graduation, post graduation, that kind of a study. All of may not go in that way. Some of us require a skill just immediately after passing the 10th examination so that I can start earning the livelihood. Some of the student may require that they must be empowered to do the entrepreneurship, to become an entrepreneur. Some of them may require that they must, I am not a visual learner, I am an auditory learner. Or some of them are not auditory learner, they are a visual learner. They can learn by the experimenting, like that. So the everything, every small thing that was supposed to take care in order to make this program success on a philosophy of equity, because everyone matters. When we talk about the equity and the equity linked with the micro planning, means every small thing matters. Every tiny object, every tiny thing will matter. So that was the special focus on the micro planning. Then the other things are that preference to the ashram school for upgradation, preference to the area with concentration of a SC/ST minority for opening the school. Again, I am talking here, it is written that the preference means it is not like that the only school will be opened in that area. A school will be opened in the all area as per the need and a demand, because that's why we have done the micro planning. But focus will be given to the area where the concentration of a population are there of a SC/ST and a minority, because they were disadvantaged section, because the literacy rate, enrollment rate was very low for those section of a society, and the dropout rate was very high. Even though they are coming to the school, they were dropping out. I have seen in the Jharkhand, when you will see the season of a paddy, when the rain starts, then the paddy season comes. So very few children, they will come to the school, they will attend the classes. Why? Because they are engaged in the activities related to the paddy cultivation. Or when the winter will start, then the season of the comes, that is the forest product. So they are engaged in collecting the forest product. So at that time, the attendance in the school will be very less. So that is the individual need. that we can do with the micro planning. And that's why the midday meal scheme for providing the nutritious food and all those things, a scholarship, providing the cycle, all those things has been conceptualized and implemented. Okay, so this is that the preference will be given to open the school where the SC/ST minority population concentration are there. So it is not like that, then the other area school will be not open, other area will also get a school, but the preference will be to those area because their participation in the schooling process was very low. Then the special enrollment drive for the weaker section, those who are socially disadvantaged, those who are the economically weaker. So the special enrollment drive will be conducted so that they can be enrolled in the school, and after enrolling in the school they will get a benefit of the several other scheme like a facility of the midday meal, like the facility of the scholarship, like the facility of a bicycle, free textbook, like that kind of a thing. So the special enrollment drive for that should be carried out, and enhancing more female teachers in the school and providing separate toilet block for the boys and girls. I think we had enough discussion on this matter, that why the provision of a female teacher and a provision of a different toilet block for the boys and girls is required. Even we can include here that whatever we have discussed in the physical infrastructure part, that is the provision of a secure campus by providing the boundary wall, all those kind of a thing, why it is required, we had enough discussion to provide that the secure environment for the girl so that they can participate in the schooling process, because we are talking about the philosophy of equity. Okay, so that was the all about the equity intervention. Okay, so now we will have a small question answer session. So if anybody got any question regarding this equity intervention under the RAMSA program, you just ask me through a chat or through a voice. Anybody, any question? Any question from the equity intervention? Okay, so no question from the equity intervention, is it it? Okay, so
yes sir.
Okay, so now we will move towards the implementation mechanism. What was the implementation mechanism? Because when we see our syllabus, that is also mentioned, that discussion on the implementation mechanism. So in the implementation mechanism, there was two, three things. The first thing is that it was a centrally sponsored program, even the SSA and even the RAMSA. It was a centrally sponsored program where the majority of the fund was sponsored, means the contributed by the central government, even though we know that the education comes under the concurrent list. But the majority of the fund was funded by the central government, supported by the central government. However, there was equal participation in the program for the central government and state government. Equal participation means central government cannot ignore the state government, and state government also cannot ignore the central government. Both have been both were participated in the implementation mechanism of this program, and this program was implemented with the help of the registered society. Every state got a registered society, and the society was given the fund by the some of the fund by the state government, some of the fund by the central government. Okay, and this society was responsible for the implementation of the all thing that was visualized in the Ramsar program. Like that, when we talk about the Orissa, we have a Orissa Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan, OMSA, OMSHM, Orissa Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan. Not Abhiyan. Here it was a mission, Orissa Madhyamik Shiksha Mission. That was the society, and that society was supported by the state government as well as the central government, and this society was responsible for implementation of the policy of the Ramsar program. Like that, when we talk about the SSA, so there was a OPEPA, like that the Orissa Primary Education Program Authority. So OPEPA is a society registered by the government of Orissa, and they got a help from both the government in order to strengthen the primary and a secondary education with the implementation of a SSA and a Ramsar program. So that was the one of the strategy, because why it was a strategy, because it has a lot of a feature and a lot of a work where the government find difficult in order to execute all kind of a thing. So they have thought of having a dedicated mechanism that will be responsible for that program only, and obviously that was working under the Department of School Education, School and Mass Education, that is in the Orissa. There is a department under the Ministry of MHRD in the Orissa government. So under that ministry, there is a Department of School and Mass Education. So they were working under the Department of School and Mass Education. They means that the Orissa Madhyamik Shiksha Mission and the Orissa Primary Education Program Authority, both were working under that. And the second thing was that the central seer means we have discussed that the financial implication that was on the central part and that was on the state part was directly released to that, means in between there was a no medium or a channel for the smooth conduction of a program, because if we will have a lot of a channel, then the lot of a delay will happen. So they were directly, it was supposed that they the finance will be directly reimbursed to the society. Society will get a direct allocation of the fund for the implementation of the program, and the share of a program, when we talk about the share of a program, because I am talking that the fund will be directly released to the society. So share of a program, when we talk, it was having a different share in a different state as per the need, because some of the state are very much financially sound, whereas some of the state are not very much financially sound, or some of the state is a very small, so the revenue they are getting out of the tax is a very small, so they were not able to contribute a big money. So it was ranging in some state 50 to 50, some state 60 40, like that. Means 60 is the central government share, 40 is the state government share, like that the share was there. So it was depending upon the state to state, what is the need and requirement of the state, as per the need and requirement that was there. So now we will come to the as I have told you that this policy framework of this program was revised, and that revision happened in the 2014, means the revision was implemented with effect from the 1st April 2014. And this revision says that here the revision was in the different parameter, right, in the part of the providing the infrastructure or a quality intervention or a equity intervention, all the thing was included. So the first revision was on the part of creating the infrastructure for the school, and it was decided that the state or the union territory government will be permitted to use the fund as per the state schedule of rate. Isko bolte hain SSOR. When we see the mechanism of creating the infrastructure, like that when the educational institute or a government institute, when they are thinking of preparing a building, so there are a different agency, like at a central level we have a CPWD, okay, Central Public Works Department, and state level we also have a PWD, Public Works Department, which used to create an infrastructure for the government organization. And for creating a different type of a structure, they have a different rate. So they have told that they can either use the rate which is provided by the state schedule of a rate by the public works department of that particular state, or they can use the rate that is laid down by the CPWD, Central Public Works Department. But here we have to see that which rate is lower. Suppose that for creating a building, state PWD is quoting 1 lakh, whereas the CPWD is quoting the 90,000. So the lower will be considered, like that. And the next amendment was to increase the management, monitoring, evaluation and research, that is given the name as the MMER, management, monitoring, evaluation and research. So they have increased the fund allocation, because in order to, because we are talking that the individual need will be taken care, micro planning will be there, equity will be there. So for all those things there is a requirement of a huge fund for the research activity, because for that we have to understand the specific need. So the fund allocation has been increased from 2.2% to 4%, 2.2% to 4% of the total fund. And within that total fund, 0.5 will be contributed by the central government, and the rest 3.5 will be contributed by the state government. But that was also very much flexible. Means if some state government or union territory fails to contribute that money, then this will come from the central government. And in some state, if the 4%, that is the total, is not very much sufficient, then it can be increased up to the 5% also. So that was the flexibility was there. So that was on the part of the creating the infrastructure. Now we will come to the point on the program implementation, because when we talk about the secondary education is a comprised of various things. Like that we had one program ICT at school education. I think you must have heard of that, ICT at a school education. Okay, there was a program that is the creating girls hostel for in the school, girls hostel, providing the girls hostel. And there was another program like that, the inclusive education for the disabled, okay. And there was another program like vocational education. So and all those program is a very much required for having a qualitative and a quantitative improvement of a secondary school education, like a information and communication technology, that is ICT at a school. That was a one program, creating girls hostel, providing inclusive education setup for the disabled children at a secondary scale, and that is a stage, and that is also known as the IEDSS, inclusive education for disabled at secondary stage, IEDSS, and that the vocational education. All those things you think can link these program with the quality of secondary education. So what it has been thought, instead of running a lots of program for secondary education, all those program has been merged in the RAMSA program. Means they won't have a separate program, but it will be a part of a RAMSA program. Means suppose that I have to create an infrastructure like a girls hostel, it will be through a RAMSA. If you have to give the vocational we are supposed to give the vocational learning environment or the different vocational learning, then also it will be through the RAMSA. The school will be the inclusive education school setup, so that the other children, means the children with the disability, children with from the disadvantaged section, all those can come in a single roof, under the single roof, for the learning, enriched learning environment. Here the enriched learning environment, why I am saying, because when we think of the social constructivism of law Vygotsky, so Vygotsky says that the learning happens with the interaction. So once we will interact with the socially disadvantaged children or the disabled children, we will also develop a positive attitude towards them, and we will develop the brotherhood with them. Otherwise we know that there is a gap between those children and the other children, and the children will also get a challenge, because in the special school everything is a very much comfortable and they are getting a very less challenge for the learning. So they will also get a challenge, and from the challenge they will learn. So that was also one of the policy label change amendment that has happened in the 2014. And initially the RAMSA was only applicable to the government school. Later on, in the amendment of 2014, it was decided to bring the RAMSA, means to bring the added school under the RAMSA framework. But in the added school, all other support will be given except the development of the infrastructure and the salary part of the staff. So other what it will be, the quality intervention will be there, equity intervention will be there. The infrastructure and the salary part will be not taken care for the added secondary school, but they have been brought out. Initially they were not under the RAMSA program, but in the 14 amendment they have been brought out. The next was that the finance sharing pattern. Initially the finance sharing pattern was not very much defined, it was depending upon the situation, but here it has been defined that the central fund will be 75% of the total program cost, whereas the state will contribute 25%. And in some exceptional cases, for the some of the state like the northeastern state, okay, where the revenue collection of the state is very much less, there it will be 90:10, means 90% will be taken care by the central government, whereas the 10% only will be taken care by the state government. It has been structured now. Other thing was that to that the Ramsar Project Approval Board, PAB. Okay, so they have been brought out to look into the matter of the Ramsar, means the different aspect of a Ramsar, and which I have already told that the finance part and even the other program that we have seen, that all those things have been brought out under the umbrella of a Ramsar implementation. That is, the Ramsar means the society that was working for the Ramsar in the Orissa. We have a Orissa Madhyamik Shiksha Mission, so they have been brought under that. So this was all about for the Ramsar program, and the time is also over, but we will have a small question and answer session, and then we will end this session. So this session we will complete up to here only. So any question if you have got from the this discussion or any other previous discussion under the Ramsar, you can ask now. You can ask through the chat also if you are comfortable, or you can ask directly also by unmuting yourself. Yes, any question?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
हाँ, yes, please.
सर, जो implementation mechanism ने आपने बोला register society, वो society मतलब क्या है? जो लोग school में है, मतलब उस power, समय है वो लोग,
मैं बताता हूँ, मैं बता देता हूँ. Okay, okay. I will tell. What is that society? I will tell. Achha, apart from any question, this, that I will tell you. Biswajita, are you listening very carefully but not posing any question? I am seeing you are listening, writing.
The question was not related to Ramsar.
So, what is the question, if it is not related even?
Hello?
Hi, yes.
Hello.
I think you
are... BK Pasi developed micro teaching.
He not developed. He brought. It was developed in the Western country. He brought in the India. Developing and bringing is a different thing. Suppose that na, ye mouse hai. Suppose that I will tell that I have developed, means I have made it. But I have brought means I have went to the shop and I have purchased it and brought. So purchasing kind of a thing was not there in the case of a micro teacher, but he brought the concept and he experimented and implemented here. It was not a developing, it was a bringing. Okay, so I will reply to the Sonali question. Meanwhile, you just think of the other question also. So Sonali question was there, that related to the society. So society here means na, see, in order to carry out a different work, okay, we have a different structure in the government. The structure starts with the governance. Suppose that I am talking about the at a state level, so there will be a chief minister and their cabinet. At a central level, there will be prime minister and their cabinet. Okay, and then there will be a ministry. Okay, under the ministry there will be certain departments, and like that we have a ministry of education, then we have a department of school education and literacy, we have a department for the higher education, and within that department there will be certain organization, hai na? Suppose that I am talking about the higher education, so there is a UGC, there is a AICT, there is a medical council, there is a NCT, like that there will be some organization, some agency, better to say the agency. Within that agency, there will be some small agency. you can say that the sub agency. Suppose that I am talking about the UGC, that take cares the requirement of the higher education, that take cares the higher education. So within that there is a university. Within that university there are certain departments. So through the department, whatever we have conceptualized, visualized at a university level, that is implemented. And through the university, whatever we have thought of at a UGC level, that is implemented. And through those UGC and all those things, whatever the policy level at a government is there, that is implemented. So in order to implement the policy of a government, there is a finite structure. Okay. Another side of a finite structure is that government, these are the permanent structure, means government is a permanent, cabinet is a permanent in the sense that after 5 years when the election will come, another set of a cabinet may come, another prime minister will come, but prime minister as a post will be always there as long as our constitution is there, and this structure will be there as long as the policy is there. When the policy will change, it may change. But for implementing some short term program, we used to have a agency or an organization we used to set up, which is not very much permanent in nature. Like that, when we talk about the Orisha Madhyamik Shiksha Mission, when this RAMSA will get over, means the universal enrollment, retention, quality, equity, everything will be achieved, then there will be no significance of this structure and this may be waived off. And in fact, it happens. So many things we had and it had been waived off. So government was used to do, they used to frame a organization, and in order to give a legal identity to the organization, because once you will form a organization, suppose that you people have gathered together and you have formed one organization, you must have seen that there are several NGOs are also working in some sector for the health, education and all those things. You must have heard of the some of the NGO. Like that, we know that there is a assessment is carried out throughout the India by the Pratham NGO, and the report of the that survey is known as the Asar report. Asar report, have you heard of that Asar? How many of you heard of the Asar? If you have not heard, then please search in the internet what is the Asar report. Theek hai. You may have heard of that there is a report that says that the 5th class student is not able to calculate the mathematics of 2nd class. Is tarike ka report suna hai aapne? Ki 5th class ke bachche 2nd class ka math nahi kar paate hain, 2nd class ka jo text hai nahi padh paate hain. All those things has been identified by the Asar for the first time. So many organization works, but in order to work the organization, it must have a legal identity. Unless or until you don't have a legal identity, you cannot work. Government will catch you and put in the jail. So like that, government also used to frame some organization, like the Orissa Madhyamik Shiksha Mission. This is the organization which has been registered under the Society Registration Act 21 of 1860. There are several registration act under which you can register your organization. For sake of example, when you will open a company, so company needs to be registered. So company is being registered in the Company Act. Like that, when you see the Baba Ramdev Patanjali Peeth, so they are registered in the Trust Act. Like that, when we talk about the NCERT, even NCERT is registered under the Society Registration Act. Okay, aap NCERT ka website khol karke dekhi, usme diya hua sara detail. So NCERT is also registered under the Society Registration Act, and the government framed this organization for suggesting the different thing in the school education, what kind of a curriculum we, what we can do at a school level. So for suggestion, and obviously the suggestion will be based upon the research and extension activity. So to suggest, government has framed a NCERT as an organization. It is also registered under the Society Registration Act. So likewise, government used to frame a different organization, okay, in order to carry out the work. Okay, so that is the society. Yes, is it clear to you? I have went a very long.
Yes, yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
So I think.
Yes, yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
So okay. So any other question apart from that? Sir, may I ask a question that might? Okay. Yes, Guru Prasad, you can ask. Ha, Guru, tell me, are you typing? Sir, we all are talking about the virtual class and a virtual laboratory. It is can his question is that, sir, we all are talking about the virtual classes, the virtual laboratory, etc. Sir, can we call our thought process, dream, etc. as a virtual? Means you are talking about the virtual dream and the virtual thought process. Am I understanding correct? So, see, as per the development of the science we have up to today, we cannot have a virtual dream, and if it is there, I am ignorant of that. So to best of my knowledge, whatever development has happened till now, the virtual dream is not possible. However, the researches, as I have heard, that the researches are going on to connect the mind. Suppose that my mind will be connected to your mind. So whatever the learning I have, that will be transferred to you. So to transfer the learning, transfer the knowledge, everything, the people are researching to connect and even to input the information. Suppose that, like the hard disk, na, we store the information and we can copy the information from one hard disk to another hard disk. So like that, researches are going on. I have heard of that, I have seen, but till now there is no significant success in that. So till now I can say that it is not. And a thought process, obviously not, because thought process is a very much particular in nature means whatever the kind of experiences, knowledge, learning you will have, accordingly your thought process will work. So till the best of my knowledge, it is not possible till now. And so that's all. Any other thing? Okay, so Subhranshu is saying something, that is Elon Musk is doing that project download. Yes, I told person name I was not knowing, that was not in my mind, but researches are going on, but there is no significant success till now. And in my opinion, it is unethical also. It may be a big threat to the human civilization. So the, even when we talk about the very prominent researchers in the science, they have given a threat that this type of researches must be stopped immediately. Okay, so let's say Hawkins, Professor Hawkins, they have warned that this type of yes, Guru Prasad, yes. जो हम लोग सोचते हैं
सोचते हैं या कुछ सपने भी देखा
जो भी क्या वो घटना है या सपने वो भी फिजिकल है क्या वो घटना है या वो भी फिजिकल
है जो हम सोचते हैं सी एज पर द डिफरेंट साइकोलॉजिस्ट एंड इट हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड दैट व्हाटएवर वी सी इन द ड्रीम दैट हैज अ वेरी मच कोरिलेशन लिंक विथ आवर लाइफ That is true, it has been established. But whatever we see in the dream, it is not a real. Obviously, it is not a real. But we cannot tell them that it is a virtual also. Okay, it is not a virtual also because as per my conception that I have, that in order to have a virtual, there should be some medium like that the virtual classroom I am having. So, physically it is not possible to come at a place and talk, but through a medium, we are gathered over a digital platform, that is a virtual platform, and we are talking. But in the dream, there is no such a medium. That is, suppose that I am dreaming that I am a prime minister and I am doing so much of a thing like that. Whatever I am thinking of doing, I am a prime minister, I am doing. So, there is a new medium that is enabling me to become a prime minister and act like that at that person, that moment of a time. So, there may be different type of opinion regarding that, but in my opinion, it is an neither physical means the dream that we used to see, obviously it is not a physical, but it is also not a virtual. There may be some word or there may not be some word, I may be ignorant of that. But in my opinion, there may be a different opinion also, I don't know. But in my opinion, it is not virtual also, because when we see the dream, I leave. However, it is a dream, but we leave that.
Thank you.
So, I don't know. I have no that much exposure in that area. Okay, Guru Prasad, I don't have a exposure in that area. Better you can talk with the some of the person with psychology. They can better explain than me, because in the psychology, so many person has worked in the dream, like psychoanalytic theory and all those things. Freud talks about that. So, better you can ask to those person and they will be able to explain in a better manner. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank okay,
you, sir.
Thank you. Anything else? Okay. So, now I think that we can stop this session here. Shall we stop?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, so sir. Thank you for being with me.
Thank you,
have
sir.
A nice
thank
day.
You, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you all.